Caution! Today's episode contains major plot spoilers, so if you have never seen or played this game, I recommend you stop watching and start back at episode 1 for the best experience. Please enjoy the video. Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, and we've been bullshitting and, you know, pussyfooting around a while now. For the last two episodes, just collecting a bunch of shit, but now the moment is here to enter the Temple of Time with our new Ocarina of Time that Zelda threw in the water for us, and the song that she taught us to go with it. So let's finally see what this is all about. Very royal-looking hall. Some classic music playing in the background. This was a little chilling as a kid, because you hear these like disembodied male voices singing this song, and you just have to imagine. Computer, shut up. You just have to imagine like they're like somewhere up there in the abyss where you can't see the ceiling, and it's a very chilling feeling. You know, it's a really haunting aesthetic of this game that really gives it the feel that the game in general has, especially at this point that we're about to enter. So I hope somebody's watching that doesn't know what's about to happen, because this is definitely a big turning point in the game. And if anybody from my video gets to experience this for the first time, then it'll all be worth it for me. I know I joke around a lot, but this isn't my favorite Zelda game, but this was my first Zelda game, and it's definitely one that has a really tender place in my heart, just because of, you know, it was my first one, and the whole plot of it, it's very special to me, just for that reason. And, you know, it was one of my first video games in general, too. I played other games before it on the N64 when it first came out. I was about 5 or 6 years old when I first played this game, and yeah, so get ready, you know. If you've already seen it, you know it's about to come, and I hope you enjoyed it anyway. Pretend it's your first time, and if you haven't, sit back, relax, and enjoy what you're about to see. There are three hollows and an inscription here. Ye who owns three spiritual stones, stand with the Ocarina of Time and play the Song of Time. That is how the inscription reads. So we have those three, and we have the Song of Time, so let's play. I'm just gonna remain quiet and let. Second to check something. Okay, we're fine. We're fine. No. Alright, so yeah, now that we got a nice fanfare, the Door of Time's open, and let's see what's inside. Skylar, isn't that... that legendary blade. The Master Sword. So yes, it's the Master Sword, which at the time this game came out, it was still it wasn't a new thing. The Master Sword first came about in A Link to the Past for the SNES. So this was actually the Master Sword's second time appearing, but it still had kind of that special feel to it. But like most Zelda games now have the Master Sword, so it's not as special anymore. But yeah, this thing is almost as tall as Link, so you kind of have to wonder how he's gonna carry this thing. Some strange symbols on the floor. All right, I guess I shouldn't delay this any further. So again. Take a deep breath, grab a drink, you know, pause the video right now, go take a bathroom break, which I probably should have done because I have to go. But just we got a long cutscene coming here, so just sit back and relax. I'm probably not going to say too much on the side, I'm just going to let you guys enjoy it and just read the text as needed. So let's grab this thing. Same Link to the Past music. Oh no, that's not good. Excellent work. As I thought, you held the keys to the door of time. You have led me to the gates of the sacred realm. Yes, I owe it all to you, kid. So yes, we have a bit of we have a bit of irony going on here. You know, Zelda and Link were working to stop this man from getting to the Sacred Realm, but by doing so, we let him in. So it's kind of a self-fulfilling prophecy, I suppose, which I think is what Zelda was trying to talk about earlier. Skylar, wake up, Skylar, the Chosen One. Is this Breath of the Wild right here? Isn't this how Breath of the Wild started? Goodness, where are we? What's going on? Where are we right now? This sort of looks like the room we were in, but it's a lot shinier and spiffier. And there's a fat man.
I am Rahu, one of the ancient sages. Ages ago, we ancient sages built the Temple of Time to protect the entrance to the Sacred Realm. This is the Chamber of Sages, inside the Temple of Light. The Temple of Light, situated in the very center of the Sacred Realm, is the last stronghold against Ganondorf's evil forces. The Master Sword, the evil destroying sword that you pulled out of the pedestal of time, was the final key to the Sacred Realm. Skylar, don't be alarmed. Look at yourself.
Okay, you guys ready for this? They haven't shown us yet, and we're about to see why. And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. You pull the Master Sword, and it ages you. You become an adult.
Look, Skylar, you're big now. You've grown up.
Now, just as I said, imagine being a 6-year-old. You're playing this game as a kid, you know, doing some sword play, and then this happens to you. Like, how did that... That's got to have a profound effect. It did. I can't imagine anybody not being completely surprised by this, because no game before had ever done anything like this. Now this is kind of expected of, like, the Zelda series to do things like this, so... Yeah, I don't know. I guess there's not much else to say about that.
The Master Sword is a sacred blade which evil ones may never touch. Only one worthy of the title of Hero of Time can pull it from the pedestal of time. However, you were too young to be the Hero of Time.
So...
Oh, sorry. Hold on. I've got to move my chair.
Ugh. You were too young to be the Hero of Time. Therefore, your spirit was sealed here for 7 years. Huh. And now that you are old enough, the time has come for you to awaken as the Hero of Time. Well, do you understand your destiny?
I guess.
But remember, though you open the door of time in the name of peace. Ganondorf, the Gerudo King of Thieves, used it to enter this forbidden sacred realm. He obtained the Triforce from the Temple of Light, and with its power, he became the King of Evil. His evil power radiated from the temples of Hyrule, and in 7 short years, it transformed Hyrule into a world of monsters. My power now has only little influence, even in this sacred realm. Namely, this Chamber of Sages. But there is still hope. The power of the Sages remains. When the power of the Sages is awakened, the Sages' seals will contain all the evil power in the void of the realm. I, Rauru, am one of the Sages, and your power to fight together with the Sages makes you the hero of time. The hero of time chosen by the Master Sword. Keep my spirit with you, and find the power of the other Sages and add their might to your own. Now, there's a theory that Mr. Owl is actually Rauru, but there's a big, thing to disclaim that theory that we will see much later on. I guess I could have chosen to give him the British Mr. Owl voice just to be fun in it. And it's a fun theory to believe in, but there's something that just totally disproves it. It's actually the same theory that people use to prove that it's true, but there's I'll explain it later, it's not important right now. Just a theory I thought I'd mentioned. That Rauru is believed to actually be Mr. Owl. Whose name is actually Kaipora Gebora, by the way, but that name is never mentioned in the game. Or maybe it is, and it's maybe a Gossip Stone mentions it or something, I don't know. But that is the Owl's name. So you receive the Light Medallion. Rauru the Sage adds his power to yours. So now, we have a new fetch quest. Before we were collecting the spiritual stones, and now we have to collect these medallions from these sages. And basically, you beat a dungeon, you get a medallion. You could say we beat the light temple, I guess, or something. Back in the beta stages of this game, there was supposed to be one, and that was scrapped. A bunch of whole other things that I'll mention as we go along. I don't want to overload with too much information right now. These medallions don't actually do anything despite the description that says he adds his power to yours, but you don't actually get stronger or anything. It's just, a plot device. Find the other stages and save Hyrule. Whew. So that was a lot to take in. And make our way back to the Temple of Time. Yeah, that's a lot to soak in, You might be kind of like, what's going on? Seems a lot darker in here now. Skylar, we're back in the Temple of Time, but have 7 years really passed? It looks like you won't be able to use some of the weapons you found as a kid anymore. Let's get out of here. Now, who could this be? This isn't somebody we've seen before. I've been waiting for you, hero of time. What kind of voice should I give? When evil rules all, an awakening voice from the sacred realm will call those destined to be sages who dwell in the 5 temples. One in a deep forest, one on a high mountain, one under a vast lake, one within the house of the dead, one inside a goddess of the sand. So right there, this person here is this person of indeterminate gender is basically giving us vague clues as to where to go to find these sages. Together with the hero of time, the awakened ones will bind the evil and return the light of peace to the world. This is the legend of the temple as passed down by my people, the Sheikah. I am Sheik, survivor of the Sheikahs. As I see you standing there holding the mythical Master Sword, you really do look like the legendary hero of time. If you believe the legend, you have no choice. You must look for the 5 temples and awaken the 5 sages.
On this, one sage is waiting for the time of awakening in the forest temple. The sage is a girl, I am sure you know. Because of the evil power in the temple, she cannot hear the awakening call from the sacred realm. Unfortunately, equipped as you currently are, you cannot even enter the temple. But if you believe what I'm saying, you should head to Kakariko Village. Do you understand, Skylar? Maybe? Alright, so... This is Sheik here. We don't really know yet if we're supposed to trust them or not. They seem kind of ominous. A little scary looking. But, as Navi mentioned, there's some stuff we're not going to be able to use anymore that we found as a kid. Particularly the things made of wood or the organic things. Deco sticks, you can't use anymore. I would assume they rotted away. The slingshot also seems like it would have rotted away. It's made of wood. The boomerang is no good no more. The magic beans, I guess you can't use them after 7 years. And our Mask of Truth is no longer usable either. I guess, I don't know. Was it made of wood as well? That's possible, I guess. But everything else, our ocarina, and for some reason our deco nuts are still usable. The bomb shoes, they don't expire. Our bottles, of course. So yeah. And our magic spells. Our sword is no longer usable, and neither is our deco shield, but we don't want them anyway. We have much more powerful things, and we can now properly hold our Hylian shield. Seems a lot darker in here, and in fact, there were, actual rays of light coming through the windows earlier, but now those are gone, so I wonder if that's some sort of, foreboding sign of what's to come. So let's exit, and let's go to the oh. Something don't look right here at all. First of all, Death Mountain didn't look like that earlier. That doesn't look natural, and things don't seem as bright and cheery out here, do they? Definitely doesn't look right over here. And, oh my god, the market is gone. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, about that. It looks like shit really went down here. Now we have re-deads, but the interesting thing about the re-deads here is that they do scream, but you don't get frozen in place because the camera is kind of locked, so you can't really... There's nothing they can really... They can't freeze you in time. In place, so... That's fine. Time has not done well for this place. Let's see if our guard is still inside. Oh, this looks a lot different. Well, who are you? Oh, you are quite an energetic young man. You're brave and handsome, too. Your name is Skylar, isn't it? Don't be surprised. I can read people's minds. If I looked as good as you, I could run a different kind of business. I bet you could. My shop is the only ghost shop in Hyrule. Because of the great Ganondorf, it is a fine time for a business like this. Oh, I can only hope the world gets even worse. The ghosts called Poes are spirits of concentrated hatred that appear in the fields and graveyard. They hate the world. Young man, if you catch a Poe, I will pay a lot of money for it. So, another theory is that this is actually the graveyard kid. Because I'll just say right now, he's not... The kid you see in the graveyard isn't at all visible. You don't see him at all in this time period, except here, and it would be fitting, considering how, obsessed he was with graveyards and ghosts and stuff. But after doing this playthrough and talking to the guard that used to be here at night, and he used to talk about, ghosts and stuff, I'm pretty convinced that that's supposed to be our guard from the past. If you don't remember what I'm talking about, way back, I think in episode 3, I came here at night, and I talked to the guard that was here, and I don't remember exactly what he said, but it wasn't what I expected, and it's something I'd never read before. And he was talking about you know, like ghosts and stuff. So I might even, you know, pop that on screen to just remind everybody in case they forgot. But yeah, that's pretty interesting. There's a couple theories at work there. So let's kind of leave. I mean, see that the drawbridge is kind of dead. We don't even walk across it anymore. We just kind of... So yeah, things are not well here. Man, where do I even begin? Otherwise, Hyrule Field itself looks pretty normal. The difference is there are no longer any pea hats. And the Stealth Children will not appear at night any longer either. So you don't have to worry about that. But there will be Poes. But I will definitely talk about that much later. Let's see if any changes have befallen Lon Lon Ranch. I guess that's a good place to start. Things seem kind of normal, except we got those strange dark clouds. Let's see if Mr. Ingo still works here. Oh, Ingo's not here, but here's Malon. She's now grown up as well. Oh, a visitor. It's been a long time since we've had a visitor here. Where did you come from? Since Ganondorf came, people in the castle town have gone, places have been ruined, and monsters are wandering everywhere. Mr. Ingo is just using the ranch to gain Ganondorf's favor. Everyone seems to be turning evil. But Dad, he was kicked out of the ranch by Mr. Ingo. Oh, okay, well, that's something. If I disobey Mr. Ingo, he will treat the horses so badly, so there's nothing I can do. Well, that's unfortunate. So, let's see what's going on over here. Let's go all these horses. There are some people in Kakariko spreading rumors that I cheated Talon out of the ranch, but don't be ridiculous. That guy Talon was weak. I, the hard-working Ingo, poured so much energy into this place. I don't want any strangers like you saying anything bad about me. Listen, the great Ganondorf recognized my obvious talents and gave the ranch to me. I will raise a fine horse and win recognition from the great Ganondorf. Say, young man, do you want to ride one of my fine horses?
Tell me more.
Pay me 10 rupees and you can ride. Sure, let's ride. Do you want to hear how to ride? No, I'm good. Thank you so much. So, we got a minute, literally, and there's so many horses here, and we can see Epona. Let's try playing Epona's song. Maybe she remembers us. Oh, and she gets excited and comes right up. Well, I didn't want you, Mr. Horse. Yeah, Epona's gotten much bigger, too. So you just mount her, and when you come up to a fence, you have to speed up, and you'll hop the fence. If you go through the very center, you actually get some money, so you can win your money back. Let's do that. Oh, fuck me. Could be a little touchy trying to jump over these fences sometimes. You gotta go just the right, you can't go at an angle at all, or else the horse is just like, yeah, fuck you. You can also talk from horseback, too. By Z-targeting, you can speak to people from horseback. When you want to dismount, stop and press A. Hey, young man, do I know you? I just felt as though I've seen you somewhere before. If you use Z-targeting, you can talk to me. Yeah, I just did that. Are you ready to go home so soon? No, I want... Yeah, no. When your time is up, I'll kick you out of here. Any other seconds? 7 seconds left. But we do want our money back, so it didn't cost us anything to ride. Hey, time's up, young man. You only paid 10 rupees. You've played around enough. For 1 minute. Alright, so let's do that again. Don't listen. Let's call over Epona again. This might be a bit of a long episode. That's okay, because we had a lot of cutscenes, so we didn't really get to see a lot of interesting action. So, a long episode. Dude! You're not Epona. Stop it. I don't want what you're selling. Try to. Oh god, that was too wide of a turn. Got 5 rupees. I'm gonna try to win the other 5 back. We might need some money coming up here. Oh fuck, that was terrible. There we go. Alright, so let's talk to Mr. Ingo again. You're getting better. How about a little race with me? One lap around the corral with the horse. Let's make a little wager. Say 50 rupees? Sure, why not? Alright, this can be a little tricky, because Ingo's a bit of a cheater. But if you just try to get ahead of him as soon as... Oh man, that's not good. Try to cut the corners. But be conservative with your carrots. You don't want to run out, because they won't regenerate for a lot longer than it would be to just wait. Try to get in front of him, like this. So he can't really lap you. Okay. Unfortunately, that's not the end of it. That was only the easy race. Shoot! If the great Ganondorf found out about this humiliation, hey you, how about another race? If you win, you can keep the horse. Alright, this can be a little tricky, so hopefully... See, he kind of cuts ahead a little... Oh, shit. Corners. Oh no! That's not good. Shit, I think I lost. No, I think I lost! Oh, wait. Did I make it? I'm not sure. Oh no! Oh shit. Oh, crap. I need more money. Hold on, guys. I'll be right back. I need to get some more money. Alright. Try number 2. I'll try to be more conservative this time. I got it in front of him. That was good. Alright, we got it. Yeah. Let's try to leave. Nope. Okay. What's up with that horse? Is that Epona? How did you tame that wild horse right under my nose? I mean, it's kind of big, so it's kind of easy to do. I was gonna present that horse to the great Ganondorf, but I bet it on the race and lost. Shoot! As I promised, I'll give the horse to you. However, I'll never let you leave this ranch. Welp. I guess that's the end of the game, guys. We're stuck here forever on a ranch with a horse that we won. Was it worth it? Not sure. Actually, I guess this would be a good place to end the episode then. I guess we'll try to figure out something next time. So thanks for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know you like what I'm doing. You can subscribe for more content in the future. You can leave a comment down below. Or you can reach out to me on Twitter or Telegram at ScholarSevierico. That name will be at the end of the video and in the description box as always. Thanks for watching. I love you all. And please come back for next time on this thrilling game, The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, as we play more of it. I hope anybody who saw this for the first time was just as touched and amazed as, you know, anybody else who played this for the first time. And I'm glad at least we got to see a little bit of action in it. It wasn't all just cutscenes, so thanks. See you guys next time.